Prime Minister Sharif, let's talk about your country and as a specific example. In the face of the global health threats Dr. Tedros has just alluded to, can you talk about the systematic challenges you've negotiated when it comes to strengthening your health systems? What lessons do you think we can learn from your country's experience? But I just want to point out to the audience that you were chief, not just Prime Minister of Pakistan, of course, but also you were chief minister for Punjab for a very long time, tackling dengue, another real challenge.
Yes, thank you very much. Let me start from my personal example. In 2003, in this very country, when I was a guest of people of Saudi Arabia, I was in exile, I was struck by a very nasty cancer, adenocarcinoid. And I was flown to New York, and in Sloan Kettering, I was operated upon. I had a hemicolectomy, it was in the appendix, and I had to pay at that point in time thousands of dollars from my pocket. And I wondered how many people in my country can afford this kind of expensive treatment. And I said, not very many. Well, when I came back, mercifully, I had lease of life, so came back to Pakistan, and I was elected the Chief Minister of Punjab. And we built hospitals dealing with kidney, liver, cancer, both by the governments, various governments, and philanthropists. Without going into details, that is the point of issue, that today I think the first and foremost problem is global inequities. Now look at COVID. It exposed these imbalances, gaps, hugely. Imagine global north and global south, distribution of vaccines and so on and so forth. Two, climate change has completely changed the landscape. Pakistan does not contribute even a fraction of emissions, yet we are on the list, red list, of climate change, and in 2022, we experienced the worst climate change flux in Pakistan, devastating everything from hospitals, schools, lands, agriculture, everything. And we had to invest hundreds of billions of rupees to rehabilitate people. But when it came to the question of seeking funds from abroad, those are loans, expensive loans. Can a developing country afford that? Three, if you want to use your meager resources to provide access to decent healthcare to the people, wherever there's a way, there's a will, there's a way. That's my belief. And as Chief Minister of Punjab, I, by the grace of God, was able to provide in the far nook and corner of my province, it's a province of 140 million people, wonderful hepatitis facilities in every remote area of the province, provided with CT scans all over the province, poor people who are very in dire need of providing food and education to children, cannot waste time. So I provided CT scans in their areas, which were the reports uploaded, brought to big centers of Punjab, and then the experts would look at that and send back the report in the evening, and they would get medical facilities. Three, I was able to, by the grace of God, build one of the finest hospital for kidney and liver in Lahore, which is probably the best in South Asia. And poor people going to India, to China, expensive treatment, we offered them in Lahore, saving very, very, scarce foreign exchange and getting them free treatment who are poor, and we would charge who are rich. And this combination of cross-subsidy, we were able to provide facilities to the people. And then dengue, in 2011, it struck Pakistan, and most of all, it struck the city of Lahore, and he would bear me out. This dengue outbreak was probably the biggest around the globe. I have to confess here in front of this August assembly, I didn't know much about dengue, believe me. We collected experts, and then, from 6 in the morning till late night, I would have meetings. It was the entire government and civil society, philanthropists, experts, doctors, and common man, we all got them together. Went for lava, went for these brigades, would go out and this find various lava and trying to finish them through modern techniques. It was a challenge of sorts. I got machines flown by aircrafts and placed in hospitals, and HDUs we established in all hospitals, and I, through law, through a decree, you know, made it, you know, in all laboratories responsible to provide these dengue tests at a very meager cost. Mm. And that's how we were able to control dengue.
And that's an extraordinary thing.
Sri Lankans, just 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Sri Lankans, they gave me a flashing sign that Chief Minister, this year, you'll have deaths amounting to thousands of people. And I was dead scared. I couldn't sleep that night. But mercifully, through this collective efforts, only 250 people died. And next year, there were dengue patients, no death.
In Punjab, 100 million people? More than 100 million people?
140 million.
140 million.
Yeah, that's right. So in Punjab. Yeah. And that became a test case around the globe, a study. I think this is how we can, you know, achieve results through meager resources. But that does not mean that the yawning gap between global north and global south should not be arrested.
And I think what you've done there is really emphasize the on-the-ground work that you need to do. But of course, you also need finances. Your Excellency, Dr. Rabia, let me embarrass you a little bit by just pointing out the important role the kingdom has played. During the pandemic as chair of the G20, when it made significant contributions to finding new vaccines through support to the Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovations, and making sure those vaccines are accessible to the most vulnerable communities in the world through Gavi, the Vaccine Alliance. KS Relief and the kingdom has done extraordinary things. How has that impacted health outcomes across the world, and what more needs to be done
to
accelerate progress? I just wanted to ask His Excellency Dr. Rabia that question.
Well, thank you, Kieran. Salaam alaikum, everybody. What has been actually learned during COVID-19 is something that all of us should be careful with, that we don't repeat the mistakes that has happened because of